Hello my dear students and welcome to the class 7 of mathematics. Let's start with the chapter 1 integer and topic addition and subtraction of integer. Okay, so first we'll study step by step adding integers. Now what is integer? Integers are all the set of positive and negative numbers. So what if I am adding the integers of same sign? So if you are adding integers of the same sign, then first find out the sum of their absolute values and use the same sign as that of two integer. For example, if I am adding 5 plus 7, now both are the positive integer, so my answer is also a positive integer. 5 plus 7 is a 12. Now next example, minus 15 plus minus 7. Now see here, both are a negative integer, so answer is negative. And what is addition of numbers 15 plus 7? It is a 22. So answer is a negative 22. Now, what if the signs are different? Then first you have to find out the difference of their absolute values. Difference means what? First subtract that numbers and then use the sign of their integer of greater absolute value. Confused? Let's have some examples. Okay. Now see this example, I have two integers, that is a negative 5 plus positive 7. Both are of different sign. So I am doing the subtraction first. 7 minus 5 is how much? 2. Clear? Then next decide who is bigger, 7 is a 5 or 5. 7 is bigger, which is a positive. So answer is also positive. Let's have some another example. 5 plus negative 9. Now different signs means first do the subtraction of the numbers, like 9 minus 5 is a 4. Now who is bigger, 9 or 5? Of course 9 is bigger, which is negative, so my answer is also a negative 4. Clear? Another example, 6 plus minus 6. Now see this, 6 and minus 6, what are they? Minus 6 is the additive inverse of 6. So what if I am adding that? 6 minus 6 is 0. Now should I keep a sign here, positive or negative? No, because 0 is neither positive nor negative. Clear? So let's go to the next topic, subtracting a integer. Now same here also, but little bit different. While doing the subtraction, we have to follow some method. In that, first you have to change the subtraction sign to an addition sign, then change the sign of the second number. Means what? If your second number is positive, then make it a negative. If it is negative, then make it positive. And then just apply the rule of addition what we learn. Clear? So let's have some example. Like if I am subtracting a minus b, means what? A, this minus change to plus, and this positive b change here to minus b. And next case, a minus minus b, same, change this minus sign to plus sign and this negative b to positive b. So let's have some example. 3 minus 5. Now 3 minus 5 means 3 plus minus 5. Now apply the rule of addition. Since both are of different sign, do the subtraction. 5 minus 3 is 2 and 5 is bigger, so answer is a minus 2. 7 minus 4, 7 plus minus 4, so answer is a 3. Now 3 minus minus 5, so change this minus to the plus and this negative 5 to the plus 5. So actually it is a 3 plus 5, which is equal to 8. Minus 4 minus minus 9, so minus changes to plus and this minus 9 changes to plus 9. So minus 4 plus 9, find out the difference. 9 minus 5 is a 5 and 9 is bigger, so answer is a positive 5. Means what? Actually subtracting an integer means adding its opposite. Clear? So what should we note? That during addition, if you come across the same sign, add the numbers and copy the sign. If you come across a different signs of integers, subtract the numbers and copy the sign of larger number. While doing subtraction, change the sign, plus becomes minus and positive substrahend becomes negative substrahend, and then use the addition rules of integer. So this is the end of the session. Thank you for watching this presentation. In the next session, we will study multiplication and division of integers.